Hello class, I welcome the students of FYJC class, and this is we are meeting for our next English class. On your screen 3.3 emails. So students, this particular topic is very much known to you all as this particular medium of communication is being used to a greater extent in this modern era, so-called technological era. So let us discuss those icebreakers. So before I start with those icebreakers, let us get introduced to the word email. Yes, the word email is a shorter version of the term electronic mail. Electronic mail, that is email, is a mechanism of exchanging messages digitally with the help of internet as a communication platform. Today, email is one of the most commonly used medium of communication. So students, let's explore the world of emails through this chapter. On your screen, there are different kinds of communication. Write some of them to complete the given boxes. Discuss the importance of each of them with your partner. So yes, as you all could see the wave diagram on your screen, where the main idea is communication. And when we speak about communication, there are different kinds of communication sources. They are verbal communication, written communication, visual communication, and audio-visual communication. Each communication source do have its own significance and its own unique way of following. So when we speak about the verbal communication, that is when we talk to a person. This verbal communication may be face to face, may be person to person, or also telephonic communication. When we speak about the written communication, yes, so through letters, messages, text messages, emails, and so on, like blog writings. Okay. Next is the visual communication. So something that you could see on the screen. So visual communication could be your mobile, your personal computer screen. It could be the television. It could be the movie theater screen, and so on. And the last one is audio visual, where both the systems are easily available, where you could hear it and see it. So these are some different sources of communication, and they do give us the best of their services. Next students, let us move on to the question of do's and don'ts. Now when any communication source is concerned, each and every source do have its limitations, okay, like advantages and disadvantages. But we'll not speak about that, those disadvantages, but we'll speak the limitations of that. What are the do's and don'ts, especially when you follow the email etiquettes? Etiquettes means code of polite behavior in society or among members of a particular group. So the way you behave, your behavior, your gestures should be appropriately presented. So first we'll read the column of do's followed by column of don'ts. So as we are dealing with the do's column for email etiquettes, let us see. As you start to write an email, these are the following instructions which you will follow very strictly. Number one, have a clear subject line. Number two, use professional salutation. Number three, recheck your email. Number four, keep private material confidential. Number five, keep your email short and flawless. Stay concise. Number six, check your attachments before sending. Number seven, include your name or a signature with additional details and contact information. So these are the prerequisites what you will follow while sending an email. And as it is said that you can add some from your side as well. So yes students, from our side we could add number 8, that keep your signature simple and your name and contact info. So whatever your contact info is, your signature is, keep it as simple as possible. Next thing we can do is use common words of courtesy to keep your communication polite and effective. So these are the do's what we are expected to follow. So these are the certain norms. Next students, let us discuss don'ts. Yes. So please take note. Generally we don't start with don't, forget, don't, because it brings negativity. So many times people, when they go to write the don'ts column, they use the words like avoid or refrain from. Even you can follow the same. But here as given on the text, let us read the same. So please take note. When you are sending the email, follow this instruction strictly, that don't forget your signature. That is must. Don't use humor and sarcasm. So whenever you are writing your email, so this is one of the etiquettes you will follow, that you will not crack silly jokes and you will not use any language that will hurt the person at the other end. Okay, because take note, your email may be read out by many people around. So don't use humor and sarcasm in your writings. Next, don't assume the recipient knows what you are talking about. So students, here you can see that every time you can't assume that the person whom I am sending this email, that person will only read the email. But there may be some other people who may be very much interested in reading your emails. So please be careful. Okay. Next. Don't punctuate poorly. So students, as far as punctuation marks are concerned, be very much cautious about their usage. Punctuation marks, yes, they present the command of your language. So the usage of the punctuation mark should be very properly done. As far as full stop, comma, single inverted comma, double inverted commas, exclamatory mark, question mark. So please use them appropriately in your email writing. Next, don't hit reply all. Please take note, when you are sending an email to one, see that the same person receive your email. By mistake, if you will hit the button reply all, then that email may be transferred to all your numbers, email account numbers which are in your data. Next, don't think that no one but intended recipient will see your email. No predictions. So as I said it earlier, that it is not sure that who will read your email. Many people around in the office, many of your friends, companion or his family people may see your email. So see that when you email, the language should be very much polite. It should be very much familiar and no harsh, no humor and no sarcasm in your writings. Next, don't forward email without permission. So students, if you, tomorrow you are planning to email your friend, please keep your friend informed well in advance that tomorrow by 10 you will receive my email. So that will create a lot of convenience to your friend to attend your email. And on this note, we move on to what are some other points which you could add in don'ts. I can say that do not write an email in all caps, that is in all capital alphabets. See that you use both the alphabets, capital and small. Moreover, students, in don'ts, don't use fancy fonts and colors. So these are some email etiquettes that you will follow while writing down the email. Now, what is an email? We have discussed about it, but now let us read it for your better understanding. Email is an electronic mail, also known as email or e-mail, is one of the most commonly used services on the internet, allowing people to send messages to one or more recipients. Email was invented by Ray Tomlinson in 1972. So this is about email. Okay, it is very good service and expected that even a common man can use the services on the internet. And it is very quick, moreover allowing numbers of people to be the sender or be the recipient of the same. So hats off to the great inventor of email, and he is none other than but Mr. Rayson Tomlinson, and he invented this particular source of communication in 1972. So students, why we use email? What is the need of it? Yes, the operating principle behind email is relatively simple, which has quickly made it the most popular service used on the internet. We all are aware about it. As with a traditional postal service, for your message to reach your recipient, all you need to know is their address. Very true. If you are using the postal services, a geographical location is must, so called the address. Its two main advantages over paper mail are the speed at which the email is sent. So students, here the difference is made between the traditional postal service and the internet. Okay, so both these services, communication services, do have a messenger and do have a recipient. And the people are active at both the end. But what is the discrimination made here? Yes, we are speaking about the speed, because the speed differs. When it comes to the paper mail, the speed is comparatively less. And when we speak about the email, the speed is comparatively very much quicker. So students, at which the email is sent, practically instantaneous. Instantly the message is received by the person. Please take note the usage of the word practically instantaneous. Means in a very quick way, within no time, your email will reach to the destination where it has to be. Okay, so here, as far as consumption of time is concerned, time is consumed very less. Okay, and the lower cost. Moreover, students, the services which are offered by emails, their charges are also very less, included with the cost of an internet connection. So students, all these things are only possible on email, that you can send the messages, you can receive the messages in quick succession. At the same time, the cost charged is also very less, provided you have a better internet connection. If the connection is weak, if the connection is having too many errors or too many distractions, or if the connection is in the remote area, so-called out of the coverage area, then the problems will develop. Other than that, no problems. But students, please take note, you need to pay for internet connection. Okay, that is not at all free of cost. You need to set everything proper. You must be knowing about the routers and all that. So proper devices should be set in order to get the best services of internet. What's more, email can be used instantaneously, send a message to several people at once. Okay, let's move ahead. Email basics. Now students, as you are planning to email your friend, what are the fundamental needs, so-called the basic needs? Make sure that your email stands out because of the content and not because of sloppy mistakes, poor formatting or casual language. Students, please take note. Whenever you are sending an email to someone, something that matters is the content. The message should be proper and it should be very much true, it should be very much correct, and it should reach the person in no time. Okay, so when you are writing the email, there may be some sloppy mistakes, or your formatting pattern may be not up to the mark, or the usage of casual language. Now take note, here it is stated that all these things are not of that important. Only the content, the main topic of the message should be conveyed in a rightful manner. That is the need. Next, use a readable font in a 10 or 12 point size in your emails. So students, please take note. As far as the font size is concerned and you're writing an email, you can switch on to 10 point size or 11 or 12. These are the appropriate and very much readable font size, so the person will be happy to receive it. If you will go for number 8 or 9, then the alphabets will be very much small or almost invisible. And if you will go for 14 or 16, it will be too larger. Okay, so that will be very much untidy presentation. So see that the font size you use is in between 10 to 12. Okay. Next, now students, you are planning to send an application to an institution. Okay, so please take note, you will make proper usage of the readable font. Moreover, send job search related emails from a professional email address. Yes. If you are searching for a job, if you are searching for any admission, so that email address should be very much professional, okay, which you will get on internet. So professional email address, ideally your email address should not include some combination of your first and last name. Should include some combination of your first and last name or first initial and last name. So students, by now you all must be having your own email address, don't you? Yeah, most of you must have. Sure, now it is a need of the time. So see that when you decide your email address, it should have a proper combination of your first name and your last name. And whatever your first initial or the last initial, last name initial is. Okay. Next, here's what to include when sending job search correspondence and the email message format you should use when you are sending employment related email messages. Sorry. So students, please take note. As far as a person is sending an application in search of job, definitely he will correspond through the email services, and the message format that you use or when you are sending employment related emails, messages, it should be very much proper. Okay. So when you are sending any email, see that your email address is right and see the content you are sending is appropriate. Next, email message templates. Now, students, please take note. Template means passages, paragraphs. First paragraph, second paragraph, third paragraph. Even in your formal or informal letter or business letter, you do have your templates. That is first paragraph, second paragraph, and third paragraph, and so on. So, here are some templates I would like to present. The following email message templates list the information you need to include in the email messages you send while searching for a job. Now, students, please take note. It is something very much formal letter writing that you are an applicant and you are applying to an institution and you are sending the email. These are the templates you will be using. Use the template as a guideline to create customized email messages to send to employers and connections. So, students, please take note. Right now, we are discussing about a very, very formal emails. So, in formal emails, first it will be subject line. So, students, even in your professional letters, you have subject reference and all those words there. In the same manner, for emails, you have subject line. Don't forget to include a clear subject line in your email. Use the subject line to summarize why you are emailing. Some of the strong subject lines. So, what are the strong subject lines? So, students, please take note. You all are very much aware about it that the subject or the reference what you give should be very much precise to the point. So, what is expected from the email? Email subject line. So, these are some examples of email subject line. So, you can write application for marketing associate Jane Smith or informational interview request or thank you marketing associate interview or referred by person's name for informational interview discuss XYZ etc. So, this will be your subject line. Next is salutation. Use an appropriate salutation like dear Mr. or Mrs. last name or dear hiring manager. So, students, here we have completed with the subject line and the salutation. Now, it's time for the first paragraph. The first paragraph of your email should include information on why you are writing. Be clear and direct. If you are applying for a job, mention the job title. So, students, if you are applying for the job of librarian in a school, then you need to mention as a librarian. You will not write as a clerk, okay? But you will write as a librarian. So, this specification is very important. If you want to take the charge of the laboratory, so wish to work as a laboratory assistant. So, all these things are very important. So, job title is very important. If you want an informational interview, state that in your opening sentences. So, students, whenever the institution is planning to call the candidates for the interview, so please, they can call in. So, you need the information regarding the following interviews. Okay, next. Middle paragraph, what you will write in the middle paragraph. The next section of your email message should describe what you have to offer the employer. And if you are writing to ask for help, what type of assistance you are seeking. For example, students, if you are writing a letter regarding the sports equipments, okay? So, you will be writing in your email that what are your requirements. Okay, and what could be done if so and so sports equipments are not available? You could suggest for some further guidance and so on. So, even you can ask for an assistance, just a helping hand in the middle paragraph if you need. Okay, next, keep it concise. Students, your language should be very too much concise. Don't stretch each and every sentence like a chewing gum. Just concise it. Just be to the point. Don't make big, big, long, long stories in the emails as well as your formal letters. So keep it concise and flawless. Flawless, no spelling mistakes. Sentence formation should be very much appropriate. So that is flawless with relevant punctuations. So don't make the usage of unnecessary punctuation marks, but whenever they are very much expected to be, you please write them. And then it's time for the final paragraph. Conclude your email by thanking the employer for considering you for the position or your connection for helping with your job search. Okay, so now here you'll be thanking the employer for considering you for the said position, for the said post in his company. Okay, and also guide him with your connection for helping you with your job search. So this is what. Now, you will be ending your email by your signature. First name, last name, email address. You will give your phone number. How to CC and BCC properly. So students, when it is come to CC or BCC, it is about the carbon copy or the blind carbon copy. Tools are tricky. Please take note. The carbon copy CC and the blind carbon copy BCC tools are tricky. Sometimes they are useful, but if used improperly, they can be problematic. So students, just I want you to Google and find out what is it about CC and BCC. They are directly stated as very tricky tools. Find out why tricky, and it is also said that if they are not handled properly, if they are not handled carefully, then the matter may be problematic. Okay. So students, read the following sample email and prepare your own email. So I want you to read this email in your textbook. Okay, there are two emails given. Please read it. As the fonts are very small, I couldn't see it properly on the screen. Better you have it in your textbook. Yeah. So read it. And now, here we come to the next topic. We have learned how to compose emails. Yeah. In the present age, applications for jobs are expected to be sent through emails. For such purposes, preparing a biodata, CV and resume is required. Yes, students. So students, please keep this thing in mind that whenever you are planning to apply or to write any business letter, all certain things has become the demand of the time. For example, if you are applying, so your application must be very much enclosed with your biodata, your curriculum vitae and your resume. So let us see what is resume. Resume is a French word meaning summary. A resume is ideally a summary of one's education, skills and employments when applying for a new job. Now students, please take note. When you are writing a resume for your application, please take note, you will be writing about your school name, where it is, how reputed and self-esteem my school was, and after that, which college did you join, from where did you pursue your computer education, and from where did you pursue your secretarial course. So this will be your resume. Okay, so you will be writing a short summary about your career, that how you have made your career. Next, a resume does not list all details of a profile, please take note, but only some specific skills customized to the target job profile. For example, students, please take note, specific skills. If that particular job demands for, like, the candidate should have command over national and international languages. So he should either know two or three international languages. So German, French and Russian is the demand. So you can specify it in your resume. Okay, because that will be attached to your job profile. So they will consider your application to a greater extent. Next, it thus is usually one or at most 2 pages long. So this is the size of your resume. A resume is usually written in third person to give it an objective and formal tone. So students, please take note, when you write resume, you will not write my name is, I have done this, this is what I have performed, this is what, no. It will be very much in a passive tone, and I have secured, and the candidate have secured, and the candidate is this, and the candidate had a mastered in. So this will be the, like, addressing the third person. Okay. Next, CV, that is curriculum vitae. Curriculum vitae is a Latin word meaning course of life. It is more detailed than a resume. Generally 2 to 3 pages, or even longer as per the requirement. So students, if you have many attachments, definitely your resume will be longer in size. It will be lengthy because it will go on adding your career specifications one after the other. It will also speak about your experiences if you have taken in any firm working for them. In the same manner, even your curriculum vitae may be longer, round about 2 to 3 pages. So students, a curriculum vitae lists out every skill, all the jobs and positions held, degrees. So students, where you have taken the job, what was your position in that particular firm, okay, how much degrees you have taken, 1 degree, 2, 3 degrees, how many degrees you have taken, do you have a professional affiliation, okay, sometimes some professions, they need a license, so for that, professional affiliation. So many times the professionals are very much expected with certificates, with a license, with a validity card. So the professional affiliations the applicants has acquired, and in chronological order. Chronological order means one after the other. If you are mentioning your school, after school you will not directly jump to the degree college. You will mention from where you have completed your HSC exams. Next, a curriculum vitae is used to highlight the general talent of the candidate rather than specific skills for a specific position. So students, please take note, whenever you are writing your curriculum vitae, and if you are taking a job of a teacher, you can highlight your talent that, yes, I am good at singing, and I do have a certificate of a singing course, or I am very much good at playing any musical instrument, and my certificate is attached here with for your reference. So this you can attach as your specific skills for a specific position. Okay. Moreover, students, you can also see that when you attach, when you enclose your specific talents, see that they don't take the disadvantage of the same. For example, if you are applying for the post of teacher, and at the same time you are also enclosing your dance certificate, then they should appoint you as a subject teacher, because that is the highlighted one. You have applied for the teaching post, not for the dance teacher post. So they should not consider that dance certificate to that level, but they should just consider it that, yes, in case of emergency, we have a dance teacher. Okay. But the focus should be very much on her DEd or BEd. That is, those are the affiliated professional teaching training courses. Okay. Next, we come to biodata. Biodata is a short form of biographical data and is an archaic terminology for resume or CV. So in a biodata, the focus is on personal particulars. Please take note. So name in full. Many people, many students, they write only the first name and they give up. Now Abhishek. In one class, you will find 4 Abhishek. So how to find out? How to verify? So always see that you make it a habit of writing your full name. Some are very much good at it that they write their dad's name also completely. So please be proud of your dad's name, write his name. And if the space is very small, you can just write his initial, but the full name, complete name is must. So biodata is very much about focusing on your personal particulars where your full name is must. Then your date of birth, gender, that is male, female, religion, race, nationality, residence, marital status, and the like. A chronological listing of education and experience comes after that. So students, this is what you will add in your biodata. If you have any additional hobbies, any additional activities, you can write in your biodata. Okay. And if you have taken any job experience in any of the firm or institution, you can state it in your biodata. So that is about your email writing. Okay. And now students, the brainstorming activities on your screen. So students, you will get all these answers in the PDF notes, what I will send along with this particular video. Okay. So I want you to write all these things in your English notebook. Please practice email writing. So these are the questions and you will get all the needed answers in the PDF notes. And now, till we meet in the next class, do take care of yourself. Good care of yourself. Okay, thank you for hearing me patiently. Have a nice day ahead. Thank you. Bye.